subscribe, support, stay positive. Boom! Hello, folks, and welcome back to another live broadcast on the Tommy NC 2010 channel. Subscribe, support, stay positive. But I know we this video pre-recorded. That intro is going to be on here. So if you can support the channel, support the channel. And here's the thing. Every donation you make goes to boosting up my videos, goes to helping me get equipment that can make these videos better. And I want to make the videos better for you folks. So remember, always remember to be yourself. And why be yourself? Because you are the most important person in your life. You know, there's other people out there that are important too. But remember to be yourself. Don't let people change you, because also the fact is that you are important to yourself. Don't let people try to change you because they think it's better for the cause. You know, I understand if, you know, if they think, you know, you're drug addicted and you're dealing drugs, you know, I can understand changing somebody for that reason. But changing people thinking, well, this certain look is not good enough for you. You know, you shouldn't really be wearing that look because it's not good enough for your apparel and people won't find you attractive. Why should I have to change myself to make up to attract other people? You know, why, you know, honestly, there's nothing wrong with the look I wear, to be honest. Ladies and gentlemen, I am in here with Mr. Mark Hyder, Mr. Gothic King Cobra.
What's up?
A new gentleman that has been, it just came on here to YouTube. His name is Ed. And, Ed, what is the name of your channel?
Eddie Explores. Eddie Explores.
Ed Explores. He has one video up right now, of course, and he is looking to blow up into the universe of YouTube. And, you know, give him support. Go subscribe to his channel. Like his videos. Share his videos. Well, one video right now. He's going to be making more videos soon. I sent some other invitations out to people to come into the Hangout and chill with us. And to understand, I always say to be positive. And you could be positive in many ways, but you need to be positive to yourself. You need to be honest with yourself, because if you don't, you're just going to get caught up and forgotten about. So you need to just be yourself. As Aladdin says, as the genie said, quoted by Rob Williams, remember, be yourself. But the thing is that...
The foreign is Cobra King, right?
The what?
So speaking of Aladdin, how about Jafar and his crazy Cobra King, huh?
Yes. Yes, his crazy Cobra King. Yes, he's a... Oh, by the way, if you notice the mask behind, that's from Danny, the Cinema Stalker. And you can check him out, youtube.com/thecinemastalker. And there it is, old Hulk Hogan's... Oh yeah, eat your vitamins. Remember to eat your vitamin, kids. Because the Cobra's gonna put his Hulk Hogan's gonna take you and put you into the Cobra. I think that's another person's move, the Cobra Crutch. But you know, he's gonna give you the early swirly, and then he's gonna give you the people's foot. Oh, that's a Rock. But you know, oh yeah.
Can you imagine if the Rock had his own cooking show? Like, can you smell what the Rock is cooking?
Actually, The Rock, honestly, he has a, he is doing a show right now. It's an inspirational show where he helps people out, get to the full, their full, stance of being what they are, and to be the strongest they can. I think that's what the show's about. So, the thing is, have you ever had, I'm curious, any of the gentlemen here, have you ever had somebody wanting to change you? Not to be yourself?
Me personally, no. You know, you can't change who you are as a person. Some things are wrong, some things are right, obviously, but for the most part, no.
How about you, Ed?
yeah, I'll agree with that a little bit. You know, sometimes sometimes people can make good suggestions about things that, you know, you might want to change about yourself. And other times, you know, their suggestion isn't so good. You know, maybe it's just their opinion. You know, so it's different for every case.
Most definitely.
How about you, Mark?
I'll always be myself.
Have you ever had anybody try to change the way you think and the way you are? Have you ever had somebody try to do that to you, shift how you feel and how you think to the point where they want to manipulate you to say, this is what you should say, this is what you should do? Have you ever had somebody say that to you?
I might have seen it in the comments, but I tend not to look at those comments.
I see it a lot, honestly. I see it in real life, and I see it in the comments. Tommy, get rid of the fedora. You know, apparently not having a ball cap, okay? Say, I put this ball cap on, you know, I put this ball cap, you know, I'm supposed to look different. I'm supposed to look...
Yeah, but would you wear it without a hat for one day?
Honestly, I didn't feel any different wearing a normal ball cap. People say, ditch the suit, ditch the shirt, just wear normal clothes. Like,
I all the time ditch my intro.
Your intro is your own thing, you know. That's
yeah.
Like your expression on YouTube. You know what? Bring it down, man. Been there, done that.
It is. You know, my intro is, you know, it's basically subscribe, support, stay positive.
You actually noticed. Everyone on YouTube says, if you like my video, you like my channel, please subscribe and do the video with your friends. That's kind of how the system works, basically. I see a lot of people on YouTube do that.
And try not to be what you're trying to be. Do not try and copy other people.
Yeah. Well, the intros are, you know, I'm not saying everyone's the same on YouTube. What I'm saying is that I see a lot of people on YouTube, everyone says on their channel, if you like my content, please share, like, subscribe, and all that. So it's sort of a standard, you know, thing on YouTube. But outside
you can't actually encourage people to. You can try. There's a certain way you got to do it because you've got to be within the YouTube rules.
Now, Mark, what did you say about Robin Williams? Or what did you say here in the chat? I saw you put some here in the chat. What did you say?
Can you get your reading program? Because I couldn't read it myself.
Did you see a skit where he talked about the baseball player who did LSD and struck out a perfect game? That was a funny bit. But she was like, the arms turned to cobras.
For making something else is the greatest accomplishment. Ralph Waldo Emerson.
That is very nice. That's, you know, it's people in a world where people think they can change everything and they try to mold it into what they want it to be. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, it's the feeling of basically saying you need to be yourself. You don't let people mold you into what you think they want you should be. And a lot of times with people, they try doing that. And the thing is, hello there, man. How are you doing today? You're muted.
What's up, homie? What's crack-a-lacking in the circle today at Google Plus? How you doing?
How you doing there, man?
Check your audio settings.
Your audio is muted. Well, while you fix that, we're going to keep talking, okay? And then you just let me know when you're ready. So.
All right, I'm ready. What's up?
Oh, not much. This is a broadcast about being yourself.
Okay.
And not letting people mold. And by the circumstances when I've spoken with you, you seem like a person that's very bulky and very strong with yourself. Have you ever had somebody tell you how to be and to try to mold you into what they wanted to see you be in, too?
You know, not really. I've had people kind of give me advice that's something I don't really agree with, but you kind of just ignore those people and kind of do your own thing. Especially when you've got, like, a hobby that you're into, like, you know, for me it's powerlifting. For you it might be, you know, making YouTube videos. As long as you're convicted into what you want to do, you know, people kind of just believe the hype, and they believe what you have to, you know, what you have to say for yourself. So, as long as you're driven, I think people aren't going to really, you know.
And they criticize you what books you read.
Oh, right.
You know, but the fact is, ignore the negativity. Just ignore it. Ignore.
Yeah, exactly.
Bring in the positivity. Eject yourself with positivity. Like, because the fact is that your life is going to go by. And the fact is that you just have to sit down and say, this is my life. I'm going to direct it the way I want to direct it.
It's like and, absolutely. It's my life. It's now or never.
Yeah, along that point, Tommy, I think if you really are driven with a goal, you've got something in mind, you really don't have time to really focus on what people are saying anyways. You know what I mean? You're too focused on your own goals. So.
Right. You can't spend your life trying to please everyone else. You'll be miserable.
Absolutely.
You know, honestly, it's about not doing anything. It's about believing what you have to see. And when you steer the ship the right way, you'll see where you're going. And even if people try to force advice down your throat and then try to mold you and say, oh, I've had people say to me, Tommy, women think that you're better than them. You know, and honestly, I don't know why they would think that. You know, I may wear suits all the time, but the thing is that I don't think I'm better than anybody else. I'm an average Joe. I'm happy to be around the opposite sex, you know, women. And to be honest...
Lady, what's up? Called Come On, Feel the Noise. Awesome song by Quiet Riot.
Yes, that's one of my favorite songs. You know, honestly, it's difficult for guys like us. Hello?
What's up?
Somebody had the broadcast on and it was echoing. Okay. But guys like... What the heck?
Oh my god, Tommy hates it when this happens. Nothing will piss him off quicker.
Can somebody please keep that echo? Who is echoing? Somebody is echoing.
What about the echo? Echo,
hello?
Echo, echo. Is it the
echo?
Echo, echo.
Hello. Yeah, man, it's you. You're echoing. No, not you, but
ooh, that's smooth.
Hello. Hello. Alright. So guys like us, you know, I lost my train. Okay, the echo is back. Who's echoing? How funny.
Oh, man.
This broadcast is because I don't want the echo in here.
I knew this was going to happen.
Hello? Who's echoing?
Well, it's not me, Tommy. It's not Mark. And I don't think it's you.
Hello.
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 Somebody put some headphones on because I hear an echo.
I got my headphones. I'm good, Tommy. I'm good.
Okay, stop picking up with you.
Is it me, maybe?
Yes.
How's that?
Hello.
Still Hello? Here.
Something.
Language, Tommy, language.
No, I didn't say anything. I just...
You say, son of a baconator. That's technically a sandwich.
Hello.
How's this? Is this better?
Hello.
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 But remember, always be positive. to have that feeling of lifting up and to say that you are important because you are an amazing person. And all of us are individuals as people. Oh my God.
Uh-oh, the fedora came off, guys. The fedora came off. We're in trouble.
Can somebody please cut that freaking echo out? I'm tired of it.
Tommy,
stay positive, man.
I am staying positive. Just like I don't want to echo.
No filter on that. Oh, that's some good tobacco.
Hello. There's okay. Hold on a second. Let's check something real quickly. Hello. Hello. We as people are here to say that. Okay, I apologize for that, folks. I got the King Cobra. You have the echo, so you need to fix that. So I'm going to have you just muted for a little while. And you can unmute yourself. Unless you fix that echo problem, I'm going to have you muted. Mark, you don't have to be muted because you don't have the echo problem. Sorry, when there's different things going on in the Hangout and you're trying to do a broadcast and there's an echo, a bit of an echo, it can be that way. It can. I don't know, Gothic King Cobra. Oh, by the way, Gothic King Cobra did something very nice. I asked him a while back ago. Gothic King Cobra is known for playing music and also making wands. Mr. Gothic King Cobra actually made me a wand, and if you want to show it, Mr. Gothic King Cobra, you can show it. Apparently he has to, get it, so we'll see it here. Look at that, folks. It's like Joker wand, and Tommy and C2010 is carved into that.
That's fancy.
It is very fancy. It's very nice.
I like it.
And but you know, it's all colors that make the Joker right there. That is very epic. Mr. Gothic King Cobra made that for me, and he's gonna send that to me.
Nice.
And that is very nice. It is very epic. It's very nice. He made that. He found that on the street, he told me. And he's going to send that to me as a, as you know, Gothic King Cobra has been on my show once before, Tommy Talks, which that would be this Sunday at 9:30 p.m. And different times across the world, it comes on for you. And so I hope you can tune in on Sunday, I promise. I don't know if I'm going to have a guest, but I may just have a pretty much like a setup where I can interview somebody. And just to let you know, I got these that very nice Gothic King Cobra. Just to let you know, I got these glasses, another little advertisement out there. I got these glasses at I Spy Black Mountain. It's on Cherry Street here in Black Mountain. And also, so I won't lose my glasses, he gave me this as a nice gift for advertisement. And so now, when I have this to attach, so I won't lose my glasses anymore.
Well, that's professional, man. That's professional. I like it.
Yes, very professional. It kind of reminds me of Beetlejuice because it's, you know, it's basically white and you know, it's white and black, kind of reminds me of Beetlejuice a little bit. But, you know, have you ever had a point where somebody wanted to change you because they felt like it was in the best of their interest and not your interest? Have you ever felt like somebody did that to you? Because I've always felt that people have always wanted to change my look because it wasn't the best interest of the public. Or, you know, should you really wear that look, Tommy? You know, not today. No, I'm just like...
I know what Chris Winters always says. You can't please everyone.
Yeah, you can't. You can't please everybody. You have to be yourself. And, you know, he's, you know, is a true wordist, I have to say. Chris Perillo is, and...
People try to change his lifestyle all the time.
Yeah, people are always wanting to change people's lifestyle all the time. And the thing is, you have to do is you just have to do what you want to do and need to go with what you're doing. And you just have to say, this is my life. It's now or never. I ain't going to live forever. Yes, that's a Bon Jovi song. And then, and also, Mr. Gothic King Cobra said that also. That song, I do live by that song. It's now or never. I ain't going to live, you know, that song. But it's very nice. It's very a good song. And a lot of people say that, you know, they don't like the old Bon Jovi. They don't like some of the new Bon Jovi songs. And, you know, my favorites are, you know, Living on a Prayer. And also the other song is, you know, It's My Life, I'm Gonna Live Forever. You know, that's one of my other favorites. And let's see what Mark said here.
Never be bullied into silence. Never allow yourself to be made a victim. Accept no one's definition of your life, but define yourself. Harvey Fierstein.
Yeah. Wow, Mark, that's really good of you. Harvey Fierstein, don't let anybody bully you. Don't let anybody force you into doing what you don't want to do, because apparently it's in the in crowd. And the fact is that every one of us is unique. And the thing is, all of us have a choice to be what we want to be. And for us to roll down this hill and to go on this crazy journey, which we call ourselves, is to say for people like Ed and Gothic King Cobra, Mark Heider, and this gentleman right here, the bodybuilder. That's my nickname for him, Mr. Bodybuilder. He's going to bust a vein with his massive pecs.
I might. I just might. It's going to happen.
Ah, ladies and gentlemen, none other than Mr. Sega Camp.
Hey, Johnny.
Sega.
How you doing tonight, Sega Camp?
I'm pretty good. Usually I work Saturday nights, but tonight I'm usually having a night off for this Saturday and next Saturday. So I did not know you were doing a live broadcast, Tommy. I was just I'm in the middle of watching a hockey game right now. The Leafs are playing right now.
Yeah.
Don't be surprised if you see me turn my head this way. I'm just watching the game right over, right from out of the corner of my eye.
So you can't. Has anybody ever? The thing is, be yourself. Have you ever had somebody try to change you because they thought it was the best interest of their self to think that, you know, you.
What are you telling me about, Tommy?
Oh, have you ever had somebody try to change you because they thought it was better for their best interest and your best interest to change your look?
Not really.
You know, 2015 is almost over. It's Christmas.
It's almost beginning, actually. It's the end of 2014.
2014 is almost over. And What have we accomplished in this year? Honestly, I believe I have accomplished
new glasses.
Yes, new glasses, a new look, and a certain part of my new look. And another thing was going to a convention and meeting up with fellow YouTubers like me. And next year, Ed. I don't know if he's going to go or not, but I may be going to Vlogger Fair 2015, if I can get the money put together, I start saving up after New Year's. That's when I'm going to start saving. And that's going to be my goal, save up for Vlogger Fair 2015. And hopefully I get to meet Mr. Ed. Oh.
Yeah, tell me if you're out here. We'll see you. You can meet up with Eddie Explores.
Eddie Explores, yes. And maybe, Ed, you can come out to Vlogger Fair and you can meet all the other awesome vloggers. And I don't know, but I think Mr. Mark Hyder is saving his money already, and he is putting in piles and trying to collect it, and he's trying to make a passport.
I'm not trying to make a passport, but that's illegal. I'm trying to apply for a passport.
Trying to apply for a passport and get out of his country and come here and go to Vlogger Fair. But the thing is, to remember, folks, to be positive and to go with the silver linings of life and to understand that you're not alone in this world. And to remember to be yourself. Because if you're not yourself, you're letting somebody else manipulate your life. You're letting somebody steer that boat of life into the side of the, you know, the wall, and basically your ship goes down, and you just that person's just like, now get out of here. I have a better boat for you. You're not gonna build your own boat. I'm gonna manipulate your boat for you, and don't let people do that to you. You know, I choose to wear a suit because I'm happy in a suit, and. For people to say that,
almost like how I wear a robe, Tommy. I'm sorry. I should not be interrupting like that. But yeah, I'm always wearing this all the time in my videos now. It became a signature look now for me over the years now.
And has applied a new look, and I have given him the nickname of Butt Naked. Now,
Butt Naked. Oh, that's funny. I'll be right back.
Yes, because Sega Camp looks very unique with a mustache. Now, some people say that, my mustache, I should shave my mustache off, but I shaved it off for the Joker, and then it grew back, and I've just kept it since then. You know,
ladies love the mustache ride.
Yes, it's a very unique look, and... for instance, hey man, I have a question for you. How much do you lift?
What lift?
Like weights. How much? What's your number of lifting weights?
Like a bench press or something of that sort?
Yeah.
Recently, I just did a 365-pound bench press. Earlier today, about a couple hours ago, I squatted 500. And then about a month ago, I PR'd at 605 on the deadlift.
Wow.
Those are my numbers. Yeah. So, preparing for a meet in June of 2015.
Wow, that's awesome, man. That's really epic. Oh,
thanks a lot.
You know? You think you could ever get up to Mark Henry's levels?
Mark Henry is not even a human being, let me tell you something. Like, he made a big name in the WWE, but he was a really popular figure in powerlifting before that in the 90s, and a lot of people regard him as the strongest natural powerlifter of all time. He still holds plenty of world records, so I'll never get to that level because that guy is not even a human being.
He's a human. He has flesh and blood, but, you know, the thing is, Mark Henry. Folks, we have topics. It says one topic, but if we go back, we will change the topic to other things after we do the broadcast. Remember, the topic is always be yourself, but when we get on different subjects, it's different other subjects we can get into, and, professional wrestling, it's a
song. Whoa. Music.
Yeah, we can't play that kind of music, man. Because this hangout will get flagged if you. I'm sorry to do that to you, Gothic King Cobra, but we can't play those kind of songs on the broadcast.
We don't have the money to pay Bon Jovi.
Oh yeah, yeah. I barely make enough as a service clerk at a grocery store. It's like, Mr. Bon Jovi, can you spare me flagging my video? Here's $100, you know. That's a drop in the bucket. Flag his video.
Everybody wants a slice of the pie, and Bon Jovi's no exception.
Yes, and it's surprising how YouTube can just jump up, and they're just like, "We hear copyrighted music. We're gonna put a notice on your video and make sure you can't do live broadcasts." And I'm like, "You're punishing me because I didn't know the music was playing in the background." They did that with one of my videos. They took the monetization off of it. And I'm just like,
"Oh wow,
really?" Really? I'm like, "You're stupid." So I took down the video. It's my rap concert. And it was really stupid. It was like, okay, it was like you could barely hear it in the background. And they recognized it, some old song. And they're just like, "Oh, monetization taken off because we don't like that. We won't want that. We don't want to hear that in the background because you're going to be trying to make money off it." I'm not making money off the song. I'm making money off the fact that my image. I mean, you know, everybody has their own ways of doing things. Everybody has to
protect. By the way, Tommy, I saw the Boontini live. I loved it. It's so catchy, man. It's been stuck in my head.
Oh, folks, by the way, there's a new song out, and I'm going to be, hold on a second. You know what? I'm going to be playing it here. I'm going to play it here, and also I'll be playing it on Tommy Talks.
Oh, that game again.
Sorry. What's the name of that new song, Tommy?
It's called "I Hit That Money and I Told You So."
That one's real catchy.
I like that's that one.
Good one. Yeah.
It's on Reverb Nation, and you can see it there. And let me just play the song. I have it here on my. Dang it. I'm trying to find it. Okay, here it goes, folks. Money, 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 money. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. No one expected from an old codger like me. Sitting on the side of the street with my buddy doing nothing all day. Truck pulled up, you went to go milk your prostate. I told you not to leave, but you left anyway, 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 anyway. I took out that gun, made a soap like John Dillinger, the true bank robber. No one was expecting an old codger like me to rob a pay truck professionally. I had to wait a whole 20 years to spend the money, but I told you we're fools. I told you twice. I told you once. I told you. 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 I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. Pissing up in the air, pissing up in the air. Piss HT Fontaculous. I've lost everything in my life, mom. Now I got it back, cause I told you, fools. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. Told ya, I told ya, I told ya, I told ya, I told ya. I told ya. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that money and I told you so. I hit that. Now here's Hamza's part.
Hamza, hit that and get that. Just sit back with this jack. This mishap is riffraff. A six-pack and chit-chat was all that I wanted, but you had a vision. I hardly can see. I'm surprised I'm still living. My heart just attacked me, but hey, it's still ticking. I was milking
my pocket. Come here, you're half now.
I still can't believe that you hijacked that truck. I need a pacemaker, so throw me some bucks. Let's get some Viagra, Cialis, and such. In luck with the bitches, since you got the riches. You don't make the money, and we love the tits. It's a perfect equation in your situation. But I can't remember, who are these two Asians? They look so erotic, the hook, I forgot it. This Alzheimer's, old-timer's mind is neurotic. Yes, this money's mine, you don't mind how I got it, cuz.
Folks, that was the new,
Not bad.
Tommy, you're within your first half an hour now.
I like that. Tommy kind of reminds me of some old Beastie Boys.
I want to say something. All that song is mine. I purchased that. And I want to thank my friend Sticky Pop. He's a good friend of mine. He's here in the Black Mountain. And he constructed that song. And we will be working, it's soon to be in the future, that we're working on a music video for that song.
Ooh.
So we'll be popping out with that also. And we'll be working, constructing it. And Mr. Anthrit has joined us, Mr. Vlog Montana. He recently went
to... I hit that pussy and I told you so. I hit that pussy and I told you so.
Whoa.
I like that remix. That's a good remix.
Let's keep it family friendly.
None other than my rapping partner, Mr. Hamza Vlogs. And how are you doing there today, Hamza?
Pretty good. Is my mic on?
Yes, your mic is on.
Hey, what's good, man? MC mic controller. Tommy, yes. MC 2010, right?
Tommy, MC, NC 2010, yes.
MC or NC?
NC.
I think you do both.
Yes, Hams, I just let the viewers listen to the new song, and... you know, I think people like it. People really do like it. And
tell me, Tommy, when you listen to it, do you feel like, you know, when we recorded the vocals to that, we were actually using a different backing track, and our producer said that it was the same beats per minute as the track that we ended up getting in the final product. But to me, it sounds like my recording is not really on the beat.
I think your recording sounds good, Hamza. You know, I really think that you said that you lost the, what was it, the, I can't remember what you said you lost.
Marbles.
No, not the marbles. You lost the beat to the song or something like that. You said you forgot. You even said in the song, I forgot the,
I said the hook, you know, the part that you do. I hit that money and I told you so. I said I forgot it because you said in the setting for this song that we were two old men. And so I was basically playing the part of an old man with amnesia. Hold on for just a second. Hello? What do you need? Then ask.
What do I
do with
the Candyland board?
We threw it away. I mean, the rest of the game. I'll talk to you later.
If you guys notice, where Hams is standing is where I shot my my new video.
The intro.
My intro video. Right. I stood in a certain spot in that room, and I did my intro, which is on every one of my videos now. And I actually, Hans gave me the idea, but I got the idea from Chris Perillo because he has all his intro on his videos. So I said, you know what, Chris Perillo says, thank you, but I wanted to make my own style. I was going to make like an hour and a half intro, but Hans told me it's like 3 minutes.
3 seconds.
3 seconds or less. And if you watch the spoof videos, if you watch the... basically, I would go into doing it, and I was like, that's not 3 minutes, Tommy.
Three seconds. 3 seconds isn't really much time to say much, is it?
No, it's not.
You could have just said Buntini, 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 and that would have been cool.
You know, Hamza, the broadcast is about be yourself. Have you ever had somebody try to tell you how to be?
I know it's not really exactly what you mean, but, a lot of times I make up fictional words, you know? Oh, sorry, my alarm went off. I gotta go take something out of the oven, but, a lot of times I make up fictional words, like, if I'm upset with somebody, I'll call them something like a balumpo, which doesn't really mean anything, but, you know, I kind of get my point across with my tone of voice. And a lot of times I've got this friend, if I make up a fictional word, he basically tells me I'm insane. And, yeah, he wears a fedora hat, and I just pay him no mind, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, I'm going to make up words, whatever. He even embraced one of my words, Buntini, but then he didn't like any of the other words I ever made up. He just said, Buntini rules, and it kills all the other fictional words. But I think I'll keep making up words, man, and being myself so I can stool my drool and rip my sip. You know what I'm saying?
Speak your word.
You know, just recently, I got a package in the mail, and it's, I think at one point I'll show in the vlog, but it's from Mr. Vlog Montana.
I'll be right back.
Anthony?
Hey, what's up? Hello? Hello? Okay. Hanging up on you. Somebody called me, apparently, for some reason. But, it's the vision of just being yourself. And don't let anybody tell you how to be yourself, you know, because you know how to be yourself. And the thing is, like, guys like me and Hamza... You look like yourself,
Tommy.
It's what?
You look like yourself. You don't look any different.
Thanks for pointing that out, Anthony. I appreciate that.
Smoking it up.
What about me, Anthony? Do I at least look like myself?
You look like a camp to me.
Thanks.
You know,
I have this misty facial hair, but by next year I was going to shave it off. Yes, everybody who still watches my YouTube channel, this is coming off. Only next year, though. The beginning of next year, it's coming off. I'll probably have, I'll make it, an update video, and then I'll be all like, yeah, I still have the facial hair.
Okay.
And then it'll switch into, a comedy spoof for, a minute where I just quickly rush into the bathroom, grab the razor, and be like, I must shave.
Folks, let's take a vote on it. The highest is 100 and the lowest is 1. So who thinks that, let's take a vote in the chat and see if Mr. Sega can be a vlogger. Now, I'm not trying to change his definition of anything, but I think Mr. Sega Camp here would be an awesome vlogger because, you know, he lives in Canada. You know, he says he doesn't have a lot to do, but the thing is, it's just about expressing yourself. I think he'd be cool because here I'm playing this game right now. You know, it's epic, it's amazing, and I wear a cap, and I had to get out of my brain. Yeah. That's my impression of wear camp. It's like, hi, I'm wear camp.
Just for one reason, though, Tommy. I used to have trolls coming across my channel for years. I've been always getting attacked by random people. People thought I was a ridicule for some reason. That's one of the reasons why I made Wear Camp. I'm just trying to go fend these haters off and show them that if you do that if you do try him doing it long enough, Ware Campbell will finally come out, and he will rip you a new asshole.
And I think that one thing would be kind of cool to see in your if you did vlogs, if you had two different segments at one point where you're so mad you read your comments, you transform into Ware Camp, and you could cut it to your vlog segment to a certain part, and then it looks like you basically, like, you can edit it to make it look like your eyes are getting red and you transferred into Ware Camp. You know, I think it'd be kind of cool. Yes,
but I just don't know how to really make it. I don't know if I'll ever try doing a transformation thing where I slowly start transitioning to Ware Camp. I don't know how I could actually do it, though, Tommy.
Well, all it does is take editing software and, you know, some good editing software, a good background for you to stand behind. And, you know, I could think of
like
many reasons.
Trying to think, like I'm a Marvel superhero or something? I don't know.
Ware Camp, becoming Ware Camp.
That would be funny, Nick. Ware Camp finally gets sold over to Marvel. That just means that they actually do need me as a superhero.
The Canadian, and once the Canadian gets angry, because Canadians normally don't get angry, they're normally peaceful.
Yeah,
people.
I'm like Bruce Banner next as the Incredible Hulk. I totally get mad enough.
That's a bad guy.
Bruce Banner. I don't think Bruce Banner was Canadian. I think he was just American. I think any Marvel character, really, Captain America, he's obviously American. You know, that's always been an expression, that the fact that every superhero is American. And has there ever been a Canadian superhero? You know, has there ever been a background of a superhero? You know, and the fact is, would that average superhero from that Canadian world get mocked from other superheroes? And it's always been a thought that, you know, of other races, there's other superheroes. You know, a lot of people said that the Green Lantern was black, and then they changed it to being white, and because Ryan Reynolds played the role of the Green Lantern, and a lot of people despise that movie because they think it was good, bad quality, and all it was a bunch of CG, and they stood in front of a green screen, miles and miles of green screen, and just shot the movie like that. But the thing is, when you're shooting a movie like that, it's kind of hard to do something like that without green screen. But people say today, in today's standards, I can tell you, this new Star Wars movie, I looked at it, and it looks amazing. It just absolutely makes my jaw drop. And I'm just like, it feels like a Star Wars movie, it smells like a Star Wars movie, and it looks like a Star Wars movie. I was scared it was going to look like, since it's this man that he directed, J.J. Abrams, he directed Star Trek, and, people had a bad feeling that J.J. Abrams was going to basically, you know, direct a Star Trek film and make it look like Star Trek, and they were going to have, how were they going to be able to tell the difference between Star Wars and Star Trek? And there's a big difference between Star Trek and Star Wars.
Yeah, Star Trek sucks.
Oh, I was supposed to be positive. Hey, but,
I was just joking. I wanted to pick a fight with somebody.
That's in the guitar of Star Wars, yeah.
Come on, Hamza. Well, I at least have liked it, The Next Generation.
Well, The Next Generation was good, and Deep Space Nine was good, and the movies were great, you know. So I was just trying to pick a fight with somebody. I'm sorry. I started to think I was in Tommy Talks because Tommy was talking so much. And I just wanted to interject for a small minute, Tommy. You can have the floor back in a second unless someone else takes it. I wanted to say, if you do decide to vlog up there in Canada, man, you know, we've got this movie series, I'm sure everyone in the world might have heard of it, called American Pie. I don't know if there's already been a movie called Canadian Pie, but my first vlog of all time on my YouTube channel was called Getting Pie, and you could start a channel called Canadian Pie. Just for your vlogging.
I don't know, Hamza.
Well, you know, one thing to remember, you know, is Tommy says that YouTube is kind of like Hollywood. You know, and in Hollywood, there's people that like to make different kinds of films. You know, some people make horror films. Some people make documentaries, you know. So YouTube is kind of that way too, you know. Some people, some people like to make video blogs. Some people like to make.
I agree on that.
Some people like to do video game.
That's what YouTube is. It's like the internet version of Hollywood, basically.
So there's all kinds of videos, you know, that people like to make.
Sure.
So Hamza, I had a question for you. What do you think about?
Sorry, I'm not taking questions right now.
Oh, you're funny, huh? I'm telling you to release the thing we've been working on for a while.
Oh, yeah, Boonschlopalope, don't drop the soap.
No, I mean, I'm talking about the other project we're currently working on. Would you like me to talk about here on the channel, or would you like me to keep that under wraps for a while?
The release of Boonschulin Blanschulin?
No, Hamza.
Free Shahid?
No, Hamza.
Oh, I know what you're talking about because of my background.
No, no, the thing we're currently working on right now here in Black Mountain.
Oh, yeah, go ahead, spill the beans, man.
Okay, folks, for a while me and Hams have been keeping this... For a while now, me and Hams have been keeping this under wraps, but I feel like it's gotten a lot of popularity. So, folks, officially now, the Food Dude Review Crew has been released now here on my channel. We've been keeping it under wraps. The fact is, folks...
Yeah,
the Food
Ed
Dude
knows...
Oh, yeah.
Ed's a big fan, and people that do follow our channel, we appreciate it. YouTube.com/FoodDudeReviewCrew. And we're very positive about our reviews. We do reviews from it's, here in Black Mountain.
Yeah, it's for the locals mostly. But, you know, we're thinking about, Tommy said we should change the name to Food Guru YouTube Review Crew Dudes.
That's a lie.
Hamza, that's a good one.
That's like catchy. That's real catchy.
No, Food Dude Review Crew is catchy, but that is not catchy. And Hamza just lied, and he just spat out a bunch of blah lies.
I think I'm kicked out of this hangout, man.
In one of his live shows, he's just chilling under the tree. What's this all about?
Hey.
So what's the new name of the show? The YouTube Rude Dude Review Crew?
Review Crew.
I'm vlogging.
I guess we'll just be, for now, the Food Dude Review Crew.
Okay.
For now.
Yes, of course.
Until the trolls Montana. Make us retreat into changing our name.
Vlog Montana is, which he's holding his camera the wrong way because he's holding it vertical, which he should hold it sideways because it takes the bars away.
That's it.
There's settings in the camera you can change if you want to, you know. You wanted to do that.
It means something, but you guys are sideways. Huh. Plus, I don't like holding the phone that way. It's easier to hold this the long way.
Ah, it's a phone.
That's what she said.
So.
Of course, Tommy.
Nice.
The old trick. That's what she.
Why said. Hold it vertical when you can hold it sideways?
Got him, Tommy. Got him.
On that note, I think I gotta go find my girlfriend.
Yeah, I gotta do stuff. I gotta get that. I told you to go.
I'm just being funny. I'm sorry, folks. That's a bit of my sense of humor. I do have a bit of a other sense of humor that when I turn the camera off. But sometimes I'm always to be the one when somebody says something like that. I'll say, "That's what she said." And, you know, it's, I got too, wordy with that one, I believe, and,
Hey, Tommy, did anyone else respond in the chat?
About what?
You said to do a vote between 1 and 100 about whether he should vlog.
I don't know, anybody wants to check that, you can check the chat. I can't really check the chat right now, because...
Right now, I think all votes are 100%.
Really?
Yeah.
You hear that, Sega Camp? Wow. Unless, you know, it's up to Sega Camp. We're not going to force him to do...
Joe Circle, Joe Live, you know what I'm saying?
We're not going to force Sega Camp to do anything. It's up to Sega Camp.
No, yeah, you're right. We can't. And harassing him would be futile and stupid. But like Ed said, man, there's lots of different types of YouTube channels. And it's a vast network, and there's a lot of choices. So, you know, whatever's cool, man. If we see Canadian Pie coming up, that'd be awesome, even if it's just one show. But
folks, I gotta go, so I'm gonna go stool my drool and rip my sip, which is a quote from Tommy NC 2010 on the song Word by Funktaculous. And
Reverb Nation, it's called Reverb Nation, and you should go check out Funktaculous, and you can download it onto your cell phones. As long as you don't resell the songs, you're okay to download it, but if you're selling the songs, you could be in a bit trouble with us and maybe some of the other people.
Yeah, Tommy's hat has actually got a razor around the edge of it. He can throw it like Kung Lao.
Well, actually, Pinky Blinders.
I put a lot of music and stuff in my videos, so, like, could I use a Funktaculous song in my video, you know, as background music?
Sure. Which song are you thinking about using?
I hit that money and I told you so.
You want the instrumental, man?
Yeah, send it my way. Send it my way.
Okay. Wait a minute. I've got your Facebook, but can I just send it to you in that? I think I can.
Yeah.
I'll hit you up. Making his appearance back here on the live broadcast, Mr. CCG Anubis from the Anubis show. And he's been in a business venture with a company currently right now, and so that's why Mr. Anubis has been away for a while. So, you know, I've been seeing the success of Mr. Anubis, but you know, we've missed the YouTube channel. We're glad to see you back on here, Mr. Anubis.
Thanks, man. It's nice to be back. I haven't seen you in a while.
Hello, my people.
It's been a while. Like,
come here, speak English, man.
How you been, man?
When I found CCG and it was, he reminded
me. Heard of?
When CCG Anubis was still active here on YouTube, I remember the first video, he reminded me of Scarface. He reminded me of Tonio Montana.
Little Frank.
And I wanted to get in touch with this guy so badly. And then when he left YouTube, I was like, oh my gosh, I outlasted a popular YouTuber. I can't believe this. And I don't know if I've outlasted a few other YouTubers, but the thing is that Mr. Anubis was one of the people that I ran into and was one of my first interviews, one of my second interviews on Tommy Talks. And I hope that, Anubis, I hope that your show can come back someday. You can have it some time to upload a video to your channel.
Yeah, man, I'm thinking about bringing it back. I don't know yet, but hopefully whenever I'm done with all of this, I'll be able to start making videos again and all that.
So, Anubis, let me think here. Has anybody ever tried to change you? Has anybody ever tried to tell you how to be? I'm curious.
Yeah, a lot of people have, man.
People have honestly tried to do that to you, try to mold you in the way they want you to be?
Yeah, absolutely.
Has it
been happening to you?
No, just to generally be yourself. Don't let the world tell you what to do. People, you can take advice from people, but just don't let people manipulate you and boss you around. Because all of us are individuals, equally. And folks, you should go check out Anubis' channel. He hasn't uploaded a video in a long time, but youtube.com/CCGAnubis, the Anubis show. How you doing there? I'm CCG Anubis. You should really check out his old videos where he started out, where he was like jumping on people's cases and you know, certain actors and actresses saying he had a crush on them. And his show, the Anubis show, was very inspirational, very entertaining, and you should go check him out, honestly. If you were a viewer of the Anubis show, you should check him out. And and also, maybe we should have a vote, unless you want us to do this, Mr. Anubis, to bring you back, your appearance to come back, a vote from 1 to 10. You know, 1 is, people didn't know him, and that's negative. I shouldn't do something like that. But if you want Anubis back, you should vote 1 or 100. You say, Tommy, why don't you vote 1 out of 100? Because 100 is high and 1 is low. But if it's a high number, Anubis, you should think about releasing videos, like little short clippets, videos of CCG Anubis' opinion on different things. or maybe CCG Anubis just, you know, it's, you know, whenever you want to come back, it's up to you. But the fact is, everybody needs their time off from YouTube. But I say, it's not all about making money. It's a, oop, we lost Anubis.
Uh-oh.
But so far, pretty much, folks, this is my message. And these are, I forgot your name, man. What was your name?
Looks like his name is Patrick.
Yeah, you talking to me? Yeah.
Do you have a YouTube channel at all?
Yes, sir. Mr. Afro Samurai. That's Afro Samurai with two O's instead of a U.
Oh, crap. Yeah, the restaurant.
That's his YouTube channel, and another than the Sega Cam Gamer, and another than Mr. Mark Hyder, and also you know him as Mr. Gothic King Cobra. He'll make yourself a wand, and also Mr. Ed Wanders. Am I right?
Eddie Explores.
Eddie Explores, Mr. Eddie Explores, and as always, folks, I'm Tommy NC2010, and I'm keeping you on the inside. Back. Thanks for watching, folks. We appreciate this. Thank you so much. We'll see you soon. Keeping you on the inside. Fact.
See ya.
Bye-bye.